But I have something more important to talk about, his pain and suffering. It's so horrible. And so hard to say what amount of money to award for his pain and suffering. The defendants tell you, when you really strip right through it and you cut right through their argument, they tell you, you know what? It wasn't all that bad. It happened essentially painlessly and quickly. No more than a minute. Maybe two. And it's over. And what are they looking for? For a minute or two of pain and suffering? He was unconscious very quickly. I ask the rhetorical question, if it were that simple, if it really were that simple, would that be the way we would euthanize our pets? Or maybe put to death our criminals? We know better. We know the science. You've heard one of the leading experts on drowning come into this courtroom. And we spent a day, a solid day, talking about the mechanics of drowning. Why? Because it is important to understand every detail of what Anthony went through. The conscious inhalation of water, the feeling that someone has a clamp on your windpipe, the breastbone is up against your backbone, you're suddenly deprived of air, you're conscious all that time, your blood pressure is dropping, you feel helpless, a sudden laryngeal reflex, loss of consciousness, and then you die. And when they carve you open like they did this little boy's body, they find lungs that are twice their normal size, sinuses full of fluid, cavities full of blood. A little boy who was playing and splashing and left unguarded 2 days earlier. 4 days earlier. And so, I need to capsulize for you, as best as I know possible, what happened in those last 2 minutes. We know what happened physiologically. Dr. Modell told us that. We know what happened anatomically. The pathologist told us that. But what happened in the little boy's mind as he slowly submerged from full of life to lifeless? And the fair reading of the evidence, all of those things that you learned about, which brought so much joy into the Slaughter's life, his dad being a cook, and his mom finishing college, and the little card that he wrote to his mom to congratulate her, and the feeling of what was happening to him, those are all fair inferences from the evidence. And what I ask you to do, please, I beg you, is to indulge me in the last 2 minutes of his life. Where is mommy? Where is daddy? Where is Greg? What's happening? Somebody help me. Someone is choking me. My chest hurts. I need air. I can't breathe. They cannot hear me. Where is that man that gave me the swim test? Where is the lifeguard? Will someone rescue me? My friends will miss me. How long can I hold my breath? If I breathe, will it be okay? Will I ever see my baby brother? I'll never go to college, just like mommy. My card, do you have it, Mom? Daddy, when can we cook? Coach Tony Jackson would save me if he could. Mommy taught me to pray. Daddy, tell me the last joke, please. Daddy, I'll never eat pasta again. Mommy, take care of my little brother. Mommy, hold me. Mommy, I remember your last kiss. Why did they fail me? Mom, thanks for putting on my shorts and hanging around. Remember the trip to the Franklin Museum? Why is my heart beating so fast? Why can't I breathe? I love to dance. And I'll never dance again. I will never see. I will never even talk. I'm proud to be a slaughter. Mommy, 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 mommy!